Good morning. So it is 7:30 and we're headed over to film the next action comedy skit. This one's gonna be a fight scene. I went to bed kind of late last night, so this morning has been kind of a rush. It's gonna be a really fun shoot. None of us wanna be in this summer heat. So we're gonna start as fast as we can and finish it as fast as we can. Cool, so we just got here, getting all our stuff out of the car. This is a harness, got the mat, rope. I got my stunt bag, all the pads in it. Got the reflector board, got the camera bag and tripod. Waters for everyone. If you're filming stuff with your friends, number one thing is make sure you get everybody waters. That's the first thing. I wrote a script a couple days ago, but what else you need is a shot list. Looks kind of like this. See all these lines? Each one of these lines is a different shot that I want to get. So basically you take a script and you break it down to what it actually looks like in your head and you write down every shot you need. So then when you're filming, you can go through this list and check these off one by one, so then you know for a fact that you can have a video that's going to edit together well. So I got the script open up on Google Docs right here on my phone. I'm writing the shot list right now while we're waiting for my friend to get here and park. My personal style of directing is, once I have what I need from the shot list, then I'll ask everybody else if they have any ideas. So we just found a little spot to put our stuff down. Got the mat, put all our stuff on it. Got everything we need. I want a beat in between the elbow. You're Napoleon or something.
Rusik's a genius, so he's setting up the shot.
No, Darren's a genius too.
And I'm a genius.
Patrick, you're a genius of the show. We always quote SpongeBob.
Hello.
Oh.
Hello.
Sweating. Fighting. We just did maybe like 15 jump spin kicks. Now we're taking a little break, and we're gonna go into the part of the fight where the tides turn. We've already worked through one camera battery. I just have to do a special VFX shot now of the Hadouken where I blast Darren and I win the fight. So we're just setting up the tripod. Darren got the wire harness on. That's what it looks like. Got all the pick points you can attach rope to. Yeah, he's also wearing a backpack underneath. And so we're just gonna put a rope on him, pull him in the VFX shot, similar to the car hit one. And it's gonna be fun. It's a really good day so far. Mary's doing an amazing job of filming.
She is.
And Darren's doing an amazing job at fighting and choreographing. And I think I'm doing an okay job.
You are.
But we've already been here for 4.5 hours. I'm gonna finish this video now, and then talk to you in a bit. Setting up the VFX shot right now. There's Darren putting on his belt. There's a pad off the screen, which is right there. You can't see. There's a rope that we're gonna pull him with. And what we're gonna do is, I'm gonna be here on a different shot. I'm gonna do a Hadouken. And we're gonna cut, we're gonna keep this camera on this tripod. And Darren's gonna walk in from off screen and just get, and I'm gonna pull him off with a rope. So then I'm gonna put those two shots together and it's gonna look like a and blasted him off the screen. And it's gonna be awesome. So that's how we do it. Practicing his falls, getting used to the pad. It's cool. All right. So you got a little loop and a little shackle that you attach to the wire vest. And then you make a little rope handle on the rope to pull with. I'm attaching the shackle to the wire vest, which is back here underneath. I'm attaching the rope through it. And it screws on like that. Then what happens is, this side the camera's not gonna see because the camera's over there. From this side, it looks fine. This saves it from cutting, because usually you cut clothes, make a little hole, and then you attach these things, but this is how we're gonna do it. Yeah, so I think we're just about ready. You ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
Action.
3, 2, 1, action. Whoa.
Woohoo! That was fun.
Action. Whoa. Action.
Whoa.
Quick side note for you guys. I really dislike it when directors or stunt coordinators or whoever it is takes multiple takes of a stunt in order to get one for safety or whatever. I really believe in knowing exactly what you want from it, and once you got it, moving on. So here in this example, Darren had to do this stunt maybe 4 or 5 times until I got one that I needed, and as soon as I got it, I moved on. A lot of people, even some stunt people, will say, oh, well, let's just get another one just to have it. I totally disagree with that. I think that when you're doing action, you need to know exactly what you need and watch the playback, and once you got what you need, you move on. Anyways, let's continue.
Action.
We are rolling.
Good.
And we just finished. It is 2 o'clock and we got to this park at like 9 something. So technically this is like a 5-hour shoot, but I think it was worth it. I think we got a lot of really good stuff we can use. Yeah, thank you guys all so much for watching. Hope you enjoy it.
Check out the link to the video in the description. It's called Pokemon Go versus Street Fighter.
So check it out. Leave me a like, comment, subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. Go check out Darren's channel. And if you want to see more videos like this, check out the creative playlist. See you next time. Peace.
Thanks so much for checking out our behind the scenes vlog. If you want to see the final version, go ahead and click the video on the left. And if you want to check out our whole creative playlist, click the video on the right. If you decide to subscribe, please make sure to turn on your notifications so you get notified with every new video that we make. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you all have a beautiful day, and I'll see you on the next video.